In the 70s, they were an elite unit with names like Brick, Champ, Brian, and Ron. They rose like the Phoenix, and then they were gone. Their legend became but a whisper, told by the trees, until now.
We're starting a 24-hour news channel, and we want you.
I'm gonna do the thing that God put Ron Burgundy on this earth to do. Have salon-quality hair and read the news. Don't
stop. This just feels right. The news team is back.
Welcome to the 80s, baby.
Is that your foot between my legs?
No.
Oh. It was my hand.
Your hair looks like wet popcorn.
I like the parts of your face that are covered with skin.
That's Jack Lime. Look at him. He's a prince.
He's not that great.
What'd you say? He said you're not that great.
Prick.
I don't read Jet Magazine or Jerry Curl Daily.
What are you doing?
I'm breaking down the barriers of race by assimilation. And on that note, which one of you convicts with the longest record can pass me the mashed potatoes?
My. Am I right? Say what?
I have to admit, I didn't like the first Anchorman. It just had a sense of humor that is not me. The best part was the Anchorman fight when they had all the people from the different stations. I thought that was hilarious. That was the only high point for me in the movie. I think Will Ferrell himself is really hit or miss. I liked Talladega Nights, Blades of Glory, not so much. I think he always kind of does the same thing, and sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. He really seems to be going very far here. The humor here is like really pushing, and I know Ron Burgundy is supposed to be offensive, but that last scene at the dinner table, like, wow. it reminds me almost a little bit of what Eddie Murphy did with The Nutty Professor, just really going there, and we'll see if Will Ferrell is rewarded for it. As I said, I don't know if I like that kind of, I'm not a big insult comic fan, so that stuff doesn't appeal to me. But I do like some of the elements they've brought in here. I love the idea of the 24-hour news cycle being addressed. I think that's fascinating. I was actually reading a story about how ESPN was started, which is 24-hour sports, I guess, so it fits in there. And they were talking about how when they started it, for like $100,000 or something, you could buy a chunk of time on a satellite on television for cable. That's how off-the-radar cable was. And I found that fascinating. You know, just like to some degree the internet a few years ago, everybody was kind of getting into this space, and now it's so hard to get into, but just to see that kind of energy and to see, you know, to be there at that time. So I like that, and I think that 24-hour news, there's a lot of jokes you can make about it because it's become so ratings-based and less about the news that I think it's ripe for parody and, you know, maybe some insult jokes that need to be said. Also, the other thing I'm excited about with this is I'm so excited to see James Marsden join the crew here. I really like James Marsden. I think Hollywood miscast him for a very long time, thinking he was a pretty boy serious actor, a heartthrob. He's a comedian, if you've watched 30 Rock or some of the other things he's done. He's a very good comedian. So the Judd Apatow kind of like picked him here. I hope that he fits well with the group, both on screen and off screen, because I know that's a very important part of the Judd Apatow kind of sphere, the networking, and I hope maybe to see him in more Judd Apatow films. So that's exciting. I will say, though, that I love Kristen Wiig so much, but I was a little disappointed to see her kind of doing the same old here, and I didn't think the joke that they used was particularly funny, the way she complimented Steve Carell. I was just like, ah, really? I mean, Kristen Wiig, they used her a lot on Saturday Night Live, and I can understand that, but I think because of that, she sometimes hit really well on Saturday Night Live and did a great job and was really at the top of her game, but then she had some really severe misses. So I think Bridesmaids did very well, but I think, I don't know, I personally am still a little wary of Kristen Wiig. So that's my thoughts on Anchorman. And also, I have to say, in New York City, I was walking home. I was just come back from the Epic red carpet. It was early in the morning, and they were shooting Anchorman 2 right in New York City near Radio City. And I noticed it because they had changed everything to 1970s. They put up like fake phone booths, and they had all these 70s cars. They were setting and resetting and driving through the scene. And I saw Will Ferrell, and I saw Judd Apatow just right there. And it was so cool. And I totally fanned out. It didn't even occur to me to film anything or try to talk to them. But I think, you know, it was a pretty close set. But it was exciting, and that actually gives me a little bit of a warm feeling towards the movie. So Anchorman 2, were you a fan of the first Anchorman, or was it not your cup of tea like me? And what do you think of the elements they're bringing in here? Do you think 24-hour news cycle is the way to go? So, and also Will Ferrell and Kristen Wiig, hit or miss all the time? Write your thoughts down below. As always, thank you for coming to be on the trailer for the latest trailers and these quick snapshot reviews. Thanks for watching. Bye.